FM.
Trafficking in persons and smuggling of migrants is a far most lucrative illicit business in the world. Assistant projects aims to combat trafficking in persons and smuggling of migrants at national and regional level between Nigeria and European Union by providing support to strengthen the capacities of the national agency for the whole of trafficking in persons. Nigeria Immigration Service, Nigeria Police Force, and Network of CS Groups against child trafficking. Beware of human traffickers and migrant smugglers. This message is brought to you by Artisan Nigeria, a project funded by European Union and implemented by FIAPP, a Spanish public foundation. For more information, visit www.artisan.com. Together, we can end trafficking in persons and smuggling of migrants.
As I said, I just want to tell you, tell him, Rampam. Okay. All right, 99.5 for Azobia FM, that we don't talk. So, landlord of Azobia FM 9 don't enter inside the studio, and they have to be like this by 7, and I know say, a tipsy voice on radio. Then they live and direct inside studio to come give you obunga informate as it take consign trafficking. Now you're going to ask yourself, what it be a tipsy? A tipsy, it mean action against trafficking in persons and smuggling of migrants. That na project will be say European Union and one jumbo body they call FIAP. Now one Spanish government public foundation, the two of them be collabo to fit carry this program package and give you will be country man and woman them inside Nigeria. I know something that they love for inside studio. Uncle Joe, he does inside studio with me. Uncle Joe, good evening.
My people, now we don't know. Now maybe Uncle Joe, person where they coordinate communication for ATEPSIN. And as soon as they don't talk, now know what ATEPSIN mean. Action against trafficking in persons and smuggling of migrants for Nigeria. And tonight we're going to discuss another important topic where we know say it concern everybody. You know, say anything will affect women, also that affect men even past. So this night we're going to discuss about preventing trafficking in women and girls, and we get experts, person where sabi this topic well. We don't work for this area for many years. She go do with us. We go call her. She go speak from Jos. Just let us know for anywhere you are. If you join us for this exception radio, so we go call her now. She's already ready to join us. Her name na Kaneng Ruang Pam. Oh, this name. I like if she join us, she will tell us.
Yes,
she will help us to.
She will use her mouth to call the name. Well,
the name. But let's try again. Kaneng Ruang Pam. Kaneng Ruang Pam.
That she will be team leader for KRP Foundation for Education Migration Awareness.
But I'm not sure I'll try for this name.
You try.
Kaneng.
You try. Bless her, she don't pick.
Hello, Kaneng.
Hello, Joseph.
Yeah.
Good evening.
Good evening.
You're live on Wazobia FM 99.5. My name is Nachinatu and Uncle Joe, they inside studio. So welcome to the program.
Thank you, Nachinatu. Thank you.
Okay.
Hello, Joe.
Yeah, my sister, I don't know. Your name, we they try to, you know, look how good for Nassan well. I hope you know more than the name well.
Oh, wow. I'll come and go to school and I need degree. So I can call my name.
I beg, help us.
Help us. Kaneng, Kaneng, Kaneng. See, yeah. Me are the pioneer staff before for Cool FM.
Seriously?
So maybe go check archive. Kaneng, I'm the pioneer staff for AIC.
Oh my God.
So yes, my household name for grassroots.
I beg, help us.
Across Nigeria.
We apologize. Oh. Just help us pronounce the name.
No, wahala. Kaneng Ruang Pam.
Okay. Kanem Ruang Pam. Wow, Sydney.
Yes, Kanem Ruang Pam.
Okay.
Okay, welcome. The first question where we say we want to ask you, now this matter of trafficking in women and girls. And you know, say today we'll discuss matter of how to prevent this trafficking for women and girls. So what does it really mean, actually, this trafficking in women and girls? What does the matter entail?
Simple, trafficking in women and girls. Now, situation where they go carry woman or carry girl from point A to B, where they exploit her. Whether my neighbor go carry the woman or the girl enter house, whether my mama and papa go release girl, go do house girl somewhere else, or whether somebody go come deceive them, say one marry them, carry and go Italy or somewhere, what they make and do prostitution, do house girl, do whatever it is, making they collect the money, naive with the trafficking a woman and girl. What they will move them from one point to the other, so that they go exploit them.
Okay, now this matter of trafficking, we know say yes it affects men, but now women and girls it affects pass. What do they really expose them to this danger? What do you mean the thing where we say they make them every time now them now they suffer from this particular human trafficking?
You know something, Chinato? No man, no value when they place on top woman. Throughout the life of woman, for when she did the left, they face abuse. Maybe the papa will say no one there, no, now boy. So now girl may go about her. As they bond the girl, I thought they're gonna suffer her. Because if boy say my last one will go to more value, spend more time, give her inheritance. That's what this girl, she can't marry. That's what the husband will they do. The whole family says that's what they're gonna do. Rich or poor, this family they went around say their wife say, we marry you, we bind you. So you don't talk for this house. These people, they husband die. True story for playing cash. This girl, 26 years old. This small boy, 17 years, the brother of the boy, the husband, one day, they want to sleep with her. Say, as my brother don't die, and then don't inherit her. You know, they won't say this one happened. So, now that's the title of abuse. No value when they place on top woman. Now, they make women and girls more vulnerable. Of equal power between women and men. When mama they house, the same thing the papa they do with the girl. You don't see talk because it's fear. If they carry the matter go house, I was saying that if the wife shut up. You know? So that's no value. Inequality, inequity. Community know they help. The culture know they help. Sometimes even people they use religion, twist them. The woman not supposed to talk. You're supposed to shut up. So if you even carry the matter out of my house, the husband could decide. Whether you go do as a medical or not, whether you go take, you don't want to move, you never reach 25, whether you go take family planning or not, even when doctor says stop. So that's all you call power, if they contribute for a workplace. If woman, it even happened to me one time, for one place I don't go mention. I marry, come that belly. After all, go maternity, they say, oh, you won't go, I have to give you a phone. I'm not going to give you leave. When you go finish, when you get strong, come back for work. But then they tell my male colleagues that one. You see, so discrimination with the low value where they place. And when I got the pay finish, come begin to go work. I thought I was going to look for our people. So that when I go to do my work for operational area, now we'll come out go breastfeed speaking with 2 months for CAPAC. You see, crash no day to even help them. What's the discrimination just day? Because of that low value for labor laws, for home. For culture, community, no value on woman. So they give what they call power between men and women. Even many men, when they rape, that's because of power. Because that's the if I do one, nothing will happen. I will feel overpower. If I go, they can't go police, I keep paying money. If they can't go court, they will give me the option of fine. So they need to get power. So it's not you, but mostly of equal power and no value where family they place. On top teenage children and women.
Oh, okay, thank you so much. I like as you take explain the thing. You know, say for some communities, women, the way that they rate them, if men they're outside, they do meeting, they're gonna say women enter inside.
Yes.
Knock door.
You're not supposed to come out.
You know what I told? Very short. That's even meal. You don't happen to me. Hmm. I get junior cocktail, meal. Every family meeting from my papa compound. I got the meeting. The sponsor boy is no show. They do around 20 years old. Yeah, I don't wait past that one. Well, then they now, and they call somebody, or the senior. They know they're not sitting down meet with women. No. Mm. I said, shoot, which day they even born this one? Go and carry for back. Mm. And today because they're the men. And they don't sit with women, do meeting.
Mm.
So it happened, Joe. Sorry to cut you.
Yeah, I saw the thing that happened. And that is why most of the value when they place on women, they're very low. And most exactly. Time, yeah. Yeah, I beg if you help us explain how these traffickers they recruit these women and girls, and what thing that they use them they do.
These traffickers, as they observe community, see the vulnerability. This is where they make people, especially women and girls, weak. You go look, which side are they talk about? Which side are they talk about discrimination or abuse pass? And then they will come use that one. Even immorality.
Yes.
For these days though, plenty parents, they don't even call us home marabba. See, bad things they happen there because mothers they cannot go to business morning to night. They don't even get time to look after the girls, they advise them. So there are some of these traffickers so because they go to schools. So they block the girls for road, when they give them leave. So when they use different things, they will buy them phone. So social factors they, economic factors they, psychological factors they, even spiritual factors they. So traffickers they observe all these factors, all these different factors every day. They go look, hey. Because they will say reach some of these girls, maybe to their friends, maybe so faster girls for community. Because girls nowadays, and they defend them more, teenagers. And then they say even then they pimp themselves. They will arrange between themselves. They say, babe, one guy go away, he says like you. So people pay me money. So make you either go sit down, chat with her. If you go just chat with her, they will never go pay. If you go out on a date, so that you would have go somewhere, go sit down, spend 5 hours, you then you will go pay me and you will call speak the money. So if they don't begin then, so traffickers really know. And they even use children, they reach them. You see? That's what we need at senior level. But as you say, this is why they fire carol, help these children. They want to when they drink, go come beat up for house. No even they just alright children go to school or not. They go see use the mama. Maybe the girl or the mama say, hey, mama, you got plenty children, no, five girls. Me, I get some, I mean, for the hairdressing, that's okay. You should say, should they do hair? And I get some friends, though. We'll see, carry and go Italy or Germany, work day or Austria. You see, this girl will set to you. So sometimes they will use, you know, these peaceful factors they talk about.
Yes.
And we use the parents, those vulnerabilities, say that they're poor. But they made them those offers. So if they carry these girls, whether now from one state to the other, for our Abuja, so many girls they will come from different parts of the country. You know, in fact, when we go Benin for our 2011, some girls there, when they come from the tribe, they are super. Now prostitution should go to Abuja. Another one now for Kano, so we'll go find them, bring them back home. You know? So whether now to move them from one state to the other, or move them to one country to the other one. Now to exploit. Exploit, they say, whether they're legitimate work or not the legitimate work, most of the prostitution that they use women do. So even for trafficking, more value gets. Men they sleep with men, no. Women they sleep with men too.
Yes, sir.
But now women are they form the biggest chunk, about 80 to 90% of this market. When they carry our girls and women come out, now to just for prostitution. How many times did they force them? So then they force them to do blue things. They force them to do hell. They go lock them for room. Because they just still get conscience. So some know what they go do. Some no know what they go do. So the ones with fear come catch them. But they don't carry them. Go where? They don't go pick up to mama or papa. Now so they go lock them for room. Nobody else will not give them water. So they begin to beg. They cry. I don't they talk. They go they beg. They go take them, they will take them, make move, you know, because they control them, and they will make them do this blue thing. So, they will say, no, they will kill you. They will say, we know where your mind is. We know your people. They will go do bad things to them. So they will enter their heads, begin to control them. So mostly in our prostitution, you know, our pornography, that then they take them to. For Europe, many of these countries, really work, as we are, you know, are not there, you know, there. But if people reach there, especially women, one thing when they legalize for some of these countries, we go Germany, we go Denmark, we go see all these things. Now, legal prostitution. Even if you go seek political asylum, then they don't carry our girl, go Austria. She go wrong. Go to our authorities, say, ah, when this person, I want to marry me, or whatever happened, no, and I just have put in my hand, no, me, I want political asylum, or whatever. She go for, but she go there one camp. So I'm going to be there for a year. So for that camp, they don't allow you work. But you can work within the kind of prostitution. Wow. So you see, like the number one thing is that.
Yes.
Now, over 61% of HIV cases, now women, in Africa globally, now women they get. And because of this unequal power and exploitation when it happened to our girl. You see, so most of them, some of them are forced labor. Some of them, before they do, they don't pick him. When we got Denmark, the head of Nigerian delegation of Nigeria will say, ah, so they put up a video for Denmark, one respectable Nigerian family. Make them get sister. And then like the sister, so that the wife sister, so the wife don't go. So they won't bring her. Then she could be their dependent, or she could be help them babysit for their house. So not be labor now for their house, and they take care of the girl. Then they get sister, and they reach them and they do different things. So you know, now so that they deceive someone, that one are forced labor and prostitution, and they illegal. You know, even for the devil, for instance, that's in a Christian state. So then they will allow prostitution for in the first place. So then they use deceit. They go trick people. They traffic them, move them. They trap them. Sometimes, as these people carry our girls go another place, even for America. Once I'm there with my family, I go for church, my uncle wife say, if you know, this is around 2004, 2005. There are some people who even come to Nigeria, come to marry girls. How did they go to America? You know, America, don't just allow you enter anyhow.
Yes.
So some they use marriage. When they reach, they say, how many girls don't die when they carry come? The men, they do anyhow with them. They exploit them. No one are trafficking, not the marriage. Some don't die. Some they should go say they will go counseling.
Yes.
Some they don't carry the girls go for shelter, for safety. They don't carry the men go prostitute because of exploitation. Even journalists from Nigeria. When they work with one of our prominent media organizations, I know I mentioned them, even though she they come out play, she they talk from there, she they do Skype. They tell other journalists, they tell people, say, this is the real look, with my education, everything. I thought it was my money from Nigeria, come America.
Yes.
Now, so I nearly die how many times? They expect me up and down.
Okay.
So,
okay, like, can
wait now. Okay.
Okay. This one now leads to the next question where I want to ask you. You know, say, don't talk within all the thing where they do. I know say your organization there at the forefront to the fight trafficking, and is also a member of the NACTA. So if you just briefly in the next 1 minute, tell us what in your organization and NACTA they do to the prevent trafficking of women and girls.
Okay, thank you, Joe.
Yes.
I'm going to divide it into two sharp.
Okay.
For NACTA, we the work with FIA, UNODC, IOM, many international organizations, and NACTIC.
Okay.
What do they do? Prevention, rehabilitation. When they do referral, when they do protection, when they bring people come, whether that's for one state or one country,
we get
about 180 members across Nigeria. All of them are organizations. Some are state-based, official is not organizational, when they work for the area of trafficking and protection of vulnerable people. When they do institutional capacity building, when they go villages, go the member organizations, when they train them, how they go identify, how they go do the campaigns against human trafficking, how they go identify vulnerable victims, how they go do rehabilitation, if they did village, the answer was not that they don't come back, what they're supposed to do to them, with the door, it's every psychological support for us in plenty. But this major five thematic areas, prevention, reputation, referral, protection, institutional capacity. Therefore, my own organization, we don't do advocacy for communities, we don't go to schools, we don't do outreaches. What we need to know, they do be research. So they talk to these young people, when we know what they know, especially about cyber trafficking, defending people on phone, all that and that.
Yeah.
When they do that research, then we go call the campaign, they tell them the truth, sharing stories, show them pictures. When they do social work, what would they help women? We don't get women who born children, one husband died, another one you wrong. When they get a, for 6 years, they even forget up with two small children.
Mm.
So when they do that one, they collect money from community. So we will help them so that they will help their children. So we also they do prevention educational programming. We they do values realignment and reorientation. Oh, the people who like they think I'm for house. Oh, they don't say woman get no get bad, no fit talk. She still contribute. If not, we they start for one leg for this country. Even your family that for one leg. So you're supposed to be equal. So everybody will figure out what you go to help the whole family. So they do that work. We also they help other NGOs. They train them. When we get training, we'll go back and train them. So that they will campaign against abuse, especially discrimination of girls who get disability. They even get more disadvantage. I don't, they talk everywhere, say, yeah, I don't get friends though. Because they get disability, not if they work out. How many marriage opportunities they need? Because the family of the people say, you know, too much for what? Now I want to get like, you know, so all this discrimination. We they advocate for health. More women they die for Nigeria because as the one born, because of this reproductive health rights. And even government, we they come there, people that do health reform. Every when they check the tobacco counter, breast counter, all these, not 10,000, 3,000 for small places. Money just to go check whether you get cancer.
Okay.
So they campaign, sending some of these things to be free or for women, to help women.
Okay, but
I also equal rights, even for offices, for you know, all that. Even the pay gap, gender pay gap today, when they pay man more than they pay woman for office.
Mm.
You know, with the campaign to end child marriage, FGM. So we want to give more women rights to inherit. So that's some of the things that they do.
All right, what open phone lines? We'll open our phone line so that people when they listen to you fit ask questions, they fit contribute for the matter where we they discuss. All right, so the number to call now 0946009995. We get Canon Rangpam inside the studio based on phone call. Now she'll be our guest speaker this evening. She'll be the team leader for KRP Foundation for Education Migration Awareness. So if you get any question, you get like 30 seconds to just call us to ask. Hello? Hello? You number is 094-600-995. The other number is 080-9032-0298. Hello? Hello?
Hello?
Good evening. No waiting behind him. Where they call us from?
I'm calling you all the way from Karamai. Did you hear me on the line?
Okay, we don't hear you.
Yeah, thank you. I'm very, very interested. But first time caller anyway.
Okay, welcome.
Yeah, thank you very much. I really appreciate all what you are doing. And my prayer, God will enlighten you and move you forward and make way where there is no way for you.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you.
Okay, that's all. Hey, all right, hello, hello, what's in the test? The number to know whether they work. Hello, hello,
hello,
good evening. Now, what's in your name? Where they call us from? Hello, good evening. What's in your name? Where they call us from? Hey, some people want to test the number. Let me next one. Hello?
Hello?
Hello? Good evening. No, what's in your name where they call us from? Good evening. What's in your name where they call us from?
Hello?
We can hear you.
Good evening. Well, as we like this. The number I get to call now 094-600-995 if you get any question or contribution for the matter where we they discuss. Hello?
Hello?
Good evening.
Good evening.
Help us reduce your radio. Hello? Hey, this one a network. Hello?
Hello?
Hello.
Good evening. What's your name and where they call us from?
It's Bella.
Okay. We they hear you.
From
we they hear you.
Ma, I want to out.
Mm-hmm. Last call, hello.
Hello, good morning.
Good evening. What's your name already?
Good evening. My name is Peter from Green.
Okay, what's your question?
I was called to greet you, neighbor.
Okay, thank you. Don't try.
Thank you.
Well, thank you. I said to go on Greece. This is yes. One I said. No, wahala.
Okay, we still get a Canon Blanc Pam for inside the matter we discuss.
Maybe we just give a minute.
Yes.
To summarize before we enter the person will win the
winner day. Okay, ma, just go ahead. You get 1 minute to summarize the talk where we say you've been get from out.
Okay. So me, I go say for family level, for work level, community level. Mm. Okay, make we check our practice. Make we check. Because if we not empower our girls, make we give them human dignity. The rights where everybody gets for house, make girls get. So that she go help herself, help her family, help anywhere we should go. We dey wahala for this country. If they affect our GDP, no time to explain them, but that one na clear science, na fact. If we imagine Olympic race, all countries they run with two legs because men and women they get equality for all levels.
Yes.
Women they even get help to do more, like in Canada.
Yes.
You know, because global research they show where they treat women well, where they know they treat them well. And Nigeria know they're on top. They behind one of the worst places where they want person think the woman. Because maybe promote. So it's not from home. Then when we check our religious practices so let we read those battles of Quran where they get you know, because some of them they treat them. As long as we know they help women, give them equal rights, give them equal opportunities, maybe they help themselves to help us. Now, so Nigeria will they suffer. Will they continue to have power issues, water issues, all the issues that they have will continue because they allow more people to go wallow in ignorance.
Oh.
More than 6 million girls know this school, you know. They get plenty, but then we help girls.
Oh.
Let we know disempower girls.
Let
me know the same girl say and put more than no go fit do anything. Then let we check our laws at all levels. With a campaign for even domestication of VAR, you know, violence against persons provision law, even use GEO. Many governments don't sign, but they never really domesticate for they never
Have
a gender commission. Government to everybody
do
something about it.
All right, thank you very much.
But they don't get respected, they don't forget anything. No. And then they don't allow any participation to do more.
Thank you.
Because it's only food.
Thank you.
Their food.
Okay, thank you very much, Kanem Grandpa. Should I get your name where?
Yes, I'll give you medal to not for.
Thank you.
So
all right, no face. We not say get so much thing to talk, but because of time, next time we'll go so engage
I know.
To sensitize our people. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
And do have a wonderful
thank you.
Night,
man. You're welcome.
All right.
Thank you. God bless you. See my sister for me. Maybe they do this tomorrow.
Yes,
we don't wait for them to pay us to do it. Can we
all right. All right.
Thank you so much. That is a coming
Rampam.
Okay,
yes.
So make we enter the winning phase.
Yes, so
we do every month with the select person we go win for the listen and win a challenge. And the one we do last week,
first no winner,
one person won it, and her name na Joy Joseph. You know, say she answered for Facebook, answer for Twitter.
Okay,
some people get them, but the only
answer for one.
Answer for Twitter, but this person answered for Facebook. And the first question now, what team be the full meaning of Etipsin? She can't answer Etipsin, mean action against trafficking in persons and smuggling of migrants in Nigeria, which is correct. And what thing do they use victims of child trafficking? They do. She even can't answer and said they use them. They do sexual exploitation. They do agricultural work, begging, and all the rest of them. Would be correct answer.
Right answer.
We don't already reach out to her. So anyway, they listen to us. You're good. inside here. I beg, you get something where there is here, maybe t-shirt. If you get this thing, I beg, wear them. Wear the cap, snap picture, and send to us. Make you not say
you don't reach your hand.
Yeah?
All right.
Congratulations. So you go there for Wazobia here.
Okay. So you can just come studio on Monday around 12 o'clock, between 12 to 2. Just come around that time and you will get your Kaya. All right. So, Uncle Joe, tell us the social media handles again.
Yeah. So, so then listen, I beg if you follow us on social media, our social media handle is ATIPSOM Nigeria. ATIPSOM, ATIPSOM Nigeria. The same name for Facebook, for Twitter and Instagram. So we encourage you, as you just finish the lesson now, just go on social media and follow all our social media handles so that you're going to get update anytime we do program.
All right, so now here we go. Close mouth on top. ATIPSOM voice on radio. ATIPSOM!
We join hands. End human trafficking and smuggling of migrants.
ATIPSOM!
We join hands. End human trafficking and smuggling of migrants.
All right, my people, my name is Ugunna Chinatu.
And my name is Uncle Joe.
All right. Fugitive persons and smuggling of migrants is the third most lucrative illicit business in the world. This project aims to combat trafficking in persons and smuggling of migrants at national and regional level between Nigeria and European Union by providing support to strengthen the capacities of the national agency for the prohibition of trafficking in persons, Nigeria Immigration Service, Nigeria Police Force, and network of CSOs against child trafficking.
Bye-bye. Good job. Well done, Kanin. Thank you.
Let's join hands to stop it. Beware of